really want to express my appreciation to the speaker for doing what he did over in the House today in not having points of personal privilege, and instead in honoring the victims and the victims' families in Tucson. Also want to show my appreciation to the governor for putting aside politics for the day and for delivering a state of the state that was really focused on the mood of today. And so with that, I'll turn it over to Senator Landrum Taylor.
We will always have this as a day that we will remember. And what happens from here, which direction we go, we set the course. We set the roadmap of that direction.
It's been a reflective time for me these past 48 hours, and it's really given me a new appreciation for being a public servant as well as being blessed enough to be born and living in this state and this country. And I hope that we can all keep that in mind as we move forward. Thank you.
This is still a loving state. This is a state that I moved many years ago after I finished my service to my country to move to raise a family. And I think it's indicative that we look at who rushed to the scene to help. It was people of all different color, all different walks of life, all different religions that were there to help out the Congresswoman as well as all the other victims. I think we need to remember that in light of what is being said. Let's not remember what one lone gunman did. Let's remember what almost every Arizonan did on that day at that mall. They all reached out and tried to help out our victims, as well as through their prayers and through their calls. They did reach out, and we have come together as a state. So please remember that, especially in these tough times. Thank you.
This for us is a time of reflection, reflecting on how we got here as a people. All the reflection has to go back to all the campaigning rhetoric and all the things that have been said. Our elders teach us that once you say something, you can never take it back. So I hope in these times we're careful about what we say about one another. It's time for healing, time for good words, words of peace, words of love. Thank you.
Senator Kyrsten Sinema.
We are all incredibly grieved about the tragedy that occurred on Saturday. We are worried, we are hoping, and we are praying for the 9 individuals who are still today fighting for their lives. And we mourn the loss of the 6 lives that occurred on Saturday. Our hearts go out to their families, to their friends. Our hearts go out to the individuals who were present at that Safeway on Saturday morning, who either witnessed or were victims of that tragedy. And in particular, we are grateful for the many, many people who, despite their own injuries, despite the fear and the chaos, reached out to help their fellow individuals. And indeed, we believe, saved the lives of certainly Gabby Giffords and perhaps others in that very morning. We have an important task in front of us here in Arizona, and that is to obviously continue to hope and pray for those who are fighting for their lives today and help them along as they recover. And as we do that, I think we have an opportunity to help our state recover, our nation, and indeed the world, who is suffering and grieving as we all are here today. And I think that we have an incredible chance and opportunity to reach forward and create a different type of politics here in Arizona, in our country, in the future. And I know that I've seen a great display of that start here today on the grounds of the Arizona State Capitol. I think David Shapiro said it well on the floor of the Senate today when he called for Tikkun Olam, the healing of the world. And I can tell you that Democrats have today pledged to begin that process and to heal our state, our country, and the world. Thank you.
I first was thrust into this when my campaign manager, Daniel Hernandez, called me from the ambulance where he was holding Gabby's head in his lap, having just acted in the most selfless way imaginable, running towards the bullets instead of away from them in order to save her life. We found him covered from head to toe in blood in the driveway of the hospital. I went in with the family. We all went in. And my 11-year-old daughter, my 16-year-old daughter, set an example for me that I've been trying to follow since then. Gabby's mom had just arrived and the rest of the family had not. My daughters knelt at her feet and took her hand in theirs. And for the next hour, they held hands. And Gloria stroked their hand and looked deeply into their eyes. And they did what they could to help her feel better. What we must all do as leaders now, despite our personal pain, is we must band together and we must make people feel better about what happened, which seems impossible at first because this is such an unspeakable act. But that candlelight vigil that night, after having spent a horrifying day with the family in the hospital, coming out, there was words that came to me that morning that I repeated to the crowd, about 200 or 300 people holding candles. It was beautiful. I said, "You can't stop hope with a bullet." The crowd started chanting and singing that. And the spirit of love and reconciliation was rising above that crowd. There was no anger, calls for revenge. It was everybody, no matter what their beliefs were, coming together and asking for love and reconciliation. And that is the spirit over Tucson right now, over all of Southern Arizona, I think over the entire United States at this point. And I believe that we will move forward from this terrible moment, and we will look back and see that we have crossed a threshold into a new day of politics in which we do not trash one another on either side, where we work together, where we follow in Gabby's model for how you work with people you don't necessarily believe with, where you work with people and understand that we are all working towards a common goal of creating one state, one nation, together, making this a better place for everybody. We may not agree with the ways to get there, but we do agree with the goal. And I was so encouraged by the words of Speaker Adams, Majority Leader Tobin, the governor today, because I believe that they will be partners in this goal, and I have pledged to them, and I pledged the governor today as well. If I have ever said anything hurtful or hateful, in spite of my best interests, they would call me on it if I ever do that. I will never say anything hateful or hurtful again about somebody else who is I have a disagreement with, because we must break this mold. We must move forward. We can, here in Arizona, show the rest of the nation how to govern in a civil manner and how to work together as a society.
Daniel Hernandez is a name known around the world today because he, instead of running away from bullets, ran towards them in order to help to save his friends and perhaps has saved the life of Congresswoman Giffords. And so I'd like to introduce him.
I come today wishing I was here under different circumstances. I speak to you all today with a heavy heart. Congresswoman Giffords was not just a boss. She was someone who I admired greatly for years. She's also someone who I considered a family friend. For years I had followed her career, and when I finally got the opportunity to work with her in 2008 on her congressional campaign, I was just extremely excited. When I had the opportunity to work with her again in 2010, I continued to be excited because Gabby is just one of those people who is the most endearing, most kind-hearted, and most approachable politicians you will ever meet. But above all, she is just a kind heart. And that's what I want to emphasize. She is still with us. She is a fighter. We know that Gabby has been fighting for Southern Arizona and all of Arizona in Congress for the last couple of years. But she is now fighting for her life, and we need to make sure that we are sending our thoughts and our prayers to her. But we know that Gabby would also want us to make sure that we are also sending our thoughts and prayers to those who lost family members on this horrific day, those who are still in the hospital, because although Congresswoman is the one who is getting most of the media attention, there were other victims, and I know that she would want us to honor these victims and make sure that we are paying our respects to them and their families. Congresswoman Gabrielle Giffords is someone who is going to continue to fight, and I know that she will pull through it, and I look forward to being able to work with her again.